Hi, my name is Mitch, and welcome to the month of December. We're almost there, guys. Only 30 days left. I'm the kids pastor here at Calvary, and here is your word for the day. I remember growing up and watching TV before you could stream your favorite TV shows. And I remember every once in a while, I'd be flipping through the channels, and I'd get stuck on one of those infomercials. I didn't like watching them, and hardly any of them would ever be anything a kid my age would have actually enjoyed. But they were really good at sucking me in. See, they were always promising that with a few easy payments and just a few small changes, our lives would be drastically different. We'd be in better shape. We could lift more. We could run further. We'd be better cooks. Our knives would never get dull. And chores like washing the car would now be fun and easy. And as I've grown up, I've even bought a few of the as-seen-on-TV items. I've had the expandable hose and the knives that are never supposed to dull and the pans that will never stick. See, those infomercials work so well because they highlight some shortcomings, some inadequacy that we feel within our lives, and we buy a little bit into the lie that these things will make our lives better. In the same way, it can be easy to buy into the lie that something besides Jesus can save us from ourselves. We know our marriage is struggling, so we think that maybe just throwing in an extra date night each month might save it. Or our kids are always fighting and slamming doors, so obviously a trip to Disneyland is going to solve it. If I just get that raise, then everything will work out. All I need is that promotion. I just need to lose some weight. I just need to get into better shape. If I just had a better spouse, if my political party was in control, if the stock market goes up, and if the housing market doesn't crash, then I'm going to feel fulfilled and secure and be without any worries. Sometimes we even put that hope for the feeling of fulfillment to come from other people. We put it in our political candidates, in spouses, in girlfriends and boyfriends, in our kids and grandkids. But the Bible urges us to only put it in Jesus and to not trust in any other false messiahs. In Mark chapter 13, it tells us, verse 21, "And then if anyone says to you, 'Look, here is the Christ,' or 'Look, there he is,' do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will arise and perform signs and wonders to lead astray, if possible, the elect. But be on guard. I have told you all things beforehand." You guys, be on guard. Do not put your faith in false messiahs. Your Messiah can't be found on Amazon. And he won't be found in the White House with an R or a D attached to the end of his name. Not all the things I listed are necessarily bad or evil, but we must look to Jesus to be our Messiah, to be our Savior. Calvary, today I encourage you to place your faith in Jesus. Trust in him as your true Messiah, the one that gives you purpose and calls you to live out that purpose each and every day. Thank you for tuning in to your word for the day. We'll see you tomorrow.